Good morning, students. So welcome to this problem session number 6. So today we are going to discuss, continue with some of the problems. So on this session, so here in the previous session we have discussed about some of the problems based on the shear stress induced in the bolt, and today we are going to discuss continuation of that and followed by some other design problems. So in this session we are going to cover some of the example. Once again, as usual, the question answer session and assigning the homework problems, multiple choice questions and references. So let us directly take down the problem. Two shafts are connected by means of a flange coupling to transmit 10 kilowatt at 1000 rpm. The flanges of coupling are fastened by 4 bolts and pitch circle diameter of the bolt is 150 mm. Determine the size of the bolt. If the permissible shear stress is the bolt material is 50 newton per mm square. So here this is the problem he has given. So first let us go on writing the given data. So he has given, once again you carefully read out the problem. Two shafts are connected by means of a flange coupling to transmit 10 kilowatt at 1000 rpm. Here he has given the power transmitted by the shaft, that is P is equal to capital P power, that is he has given 10 kilowatt. So already we have discussed in the previous sessions, so that is the conversion of kilowatt to watt, or simply you can give that value. So the power is given, so that is power of the shaft 10 into 10 raised to 3 watt he has given, and at a speed of 1000 rpm, that is speed n is the capital N, speed in revolution per minute, that is rpm. Speed of the shaft he has given 1000 rpm, and flanges are fastened by 4 number of bolts. Number of bolts are 4, that is small n is bolt, and the bolts are placed at a pitch circle diameter is 150 mm. They are placed at a in the coupling from the center of the shaft to the axis of the shaft to the, that is the flange mount. The flanges are connected by the bolts at the diameter, that is pitch circle diameter, it is 150 mm. So here write the given data. Power is 150, that is 10 into 10 raised to 3 watt, and the speed of the shaft is the n is equal to 1000 rpm, and number of bolts are 4. Similarly, pitch circle diameter of the bolt he has given 150 mm. So therefore here so we want the radius. Therefore radius, at what radius? That is diameter by 2. Already we know that. Therefore 150 divided by 2, you are getting 75 mm. So this is the pitch circle radius or pitch circle diameter. No, so from that we are going to find out the radius of the bolt. Determine the size of the bolt. The permissible shear stress in the bolt material is 50 newton per mm square. Shear stress induced in the bolt material he has given tau is equal to 50 newton per mm square. So let us proceeding further. So here, so power is given, speed is given, and pitch circle diameter or pitch circle radius he has given. So from that we have to find out the how much amount of the shear load is acting on the bolt. So already we have discussed that the basic definition of the torque definition we know, and then already we have discussed in third session, that is the power equation used for the power, within the what are the equations involved in that calculation of the power. So from that once again we have to proceed in the same manner. So already here we know that the power transmitted by the shaft is given by P is equal to 2 pi nt divided by 60. So this is the equation. So from that equation, so this is the equation. P is equal to, P is nothing but this is the power in watt or kilowatt, 2 pi nt divided by 60. So therefore here our intention is to find out the torque transmitted by the shaft. So therefore T is equal to P into 60 divided by 2 pi n. Therefore, you substitute the value here. Power is given, power is 10 kilowatt power is transmitting, that is 10 into 10 raised to 3, that is P into 60. That is 10 into 10 raised to 3 into 60 divided by 2 pi into 1000. Simply you do the calculation of this. So here P into 60 divided by 2 pi n. So here we are getting, so nearly it is the torque you are getting in Newton meter, that is 95.48 Newton meter. Already we know the unit of the torque is in Newton meter. So but the bolts and nuts are designed, so we want the dimensions of the bolt, so it is in the mm. So for that you convert this the torque, whatever the torque you have found now, you convert in the Newton mm. So Newton mm, that is just simply multiplied by 10 raised to 3, so that will you are getting in the Newton mm, that is T is equal to 95.48 into 10 raised to 3 Newton mm. So here, up to here we have arrived. Next, we have already know that the basic definition of the torque. What is the basic definition of the torque? Torque is what? It is the force into force or load into perpendicular distance or radius. So here, so this much amount of torque is acting at a radius, that is twisting moment which is acting on the bolts at a distance. This distance will come here, that is the radius or distance, that is which circle diameter he has given. So from that we are extracting the distance from the center of the shaft to the axis of the bolt. So that is known as the distance, perpendicular distance, or simply you call it as a distance. So that distance, which because of that there is a inducing of the shear stress in the bolts which are coupled to the this coupling. So therefore you use the basic definition equation, that is torque is equal to is shear load into the radius or distance or diameter divided by 2, all are same. Now you substitute the value. Already we have calculated the twisting moment torque as well as radius is known. Substitute the value. Therefore, torque is, it is the shear load PS is equal to torque divided by radius, that is 95.48 into 10 raised to 3 divided by 75. After the simplification, so here we are getting, so 1273 Newton. So this is the shear load acting on the coupling bolts. This much amount of the shear load is acting on the total shear load is acting on the coupling bolts. So therefore, now already here we know that when the bolts are subjected to the shear stress, okay, so because of the torque transmitted, so there is a inducing of a shear stress. So therefore already here we know that shear stress induced in the bolt, that is shear load induced in the bolt, based on that we are going to design the screw fastener. Therefore PS is equal to pi by 4 dc square into sigma tau into n. So you use that equation, substitute all the values. Therefore PS is equal to pi by 4 dc square into tau into n. So in this already PS is calculated, dc square we have to find out, tau is given in the problem, and as well as the number of bolts also given. Just you put the value and find out, rearranging the term for the dc square. Therefore dc square is equal to 4 into PS divided by pi into tau into n. Substitute the value, 4 into 1273 divided by pi into tau into n is 4 number of bolts, and you do the simple calculations are here. Do the calculation. So simultaneously we will also do, we calculate it, and we'll see how much value you are getting. Yes, anyone tell me how much you are getting? The simple calculations are here. Do it fast. So this is the value you are getting. So therefore dc square you are getting 8.103 mm square. So now find out the value of dc. Therefore dc is equal to square root of 8.103. So nearly you are getting square root of 8.103. Do the calculation. that is square root of 8.103. So here you are getting 2.84 mm, that is the core dia we are getting. So let us further, assuming the core thread DC is equal to 0.84D, substitute the value and find out. So here we are getting 3.38 mm, that is the nominal diameter of the coupling bolt is equal to 3.38 mm. Or so you can also use the design data book. So in that, from the machine design data book, table number 9.8, so in that, for the isometric thread, the nominal diameter, so you find out the nominal, already you know core dia for the 3.38 mm, so here 3.38 mm, so nearly we are getting 3.5, so already you have got 2.85, that is the core dia. So for that we are getting 3.5 is the standard value. You can refer anyone, either you can do with the calculation, otherwise you can refer the design data handbook. So I think I have cleared in this. So here, so let us proceed further. We will solve another problem. Take down. Two plates are fastened by means of four bolts. The bolts made of plain carbon steel, that is 35C8, with yield shear stress 300 Newton per mm square, and factor of safety is 5. Determine size of the bolt if PS is equal to 7.5 kN. So in this whatever the problem here given, in the previous session we have solved the same problem. So let us do it here. So first you write down the given data, that is number of bolts are 4 number of bolts he has given, and the bolts are made of plain carbon steel, it is 35C8, with the yield shear stress, that is tau ys he has given how much, 300 Newton per mm square. Okay, factor of safety Fs is equal to 5 he has given, and PS is all around he has given, that is shear load 7.5 × 10³ N he has given. So let us we know that from the basics of strength of material, that is, so first of all we have to find out the allowable shear stress in the bolt material. So how we are going to calculate? From the basics of strength of material, we know that is the allowable or the permissible shear stress induced in the material is equal to yield shear stress divided by factor of safety. Yield shear stress divided by factor of safety. So that is the basic. So we all know from the strength of material, that is tau ys divided by fs, that is 300 divided by 5, nearly we are getting, that is 60 Newton per mm square. This is the allowable or the permissible shear stress induced in the bolt. So this is the value we have to use for the next design process. So don't keep the value, that is yield shear stress 300 Newton per mm square, otherwise your problem becomes wrong. So you have to keep the value 60 Newton per mm square. This is the permissible or the allowable shear stress induced in the that bolt. So let us once again, so this is here the allowable stress we have found, and already we know the value of shear load, and also the this one, that is the number of bolts are also given. Next, already we know that designing of the bolt based on the shearing load is given by, so here, but here we know that the screw threads are subjected to the shear loading, and is given by PS is equal to pi by 4 DC square into tau into N. So now here you substitute the value. So here already we know that the shear load is known, tau is given, and N number of bolts he has given. Substitute all the values and find out the DC square. Therefore DC square is equal to 4 into PS is 7.5 × 10³ divided by pi into tau into tau is how much? This tau is, we have to write it as 60. We calculated into n is 4 number of bolts. So now do the calculation. So here after substitution and simplification, the DC square is value, that is 79.6 mm square. Now find out the value of the DC. DC is nothing but it is square root of 79.6. You are getting nearly how much? That is 8.93 mm. So this is the core diameter or root diameter you are finding from this. Okay, next, assuming the porous thread, that is DC is equal to 0.84 d. now you put the value, find out the nominal diameter, that is d is equal to DC divided by 0.84. substitute the value 8.93 divided by 0.84, that is 8.94 divided by this is 0.84. so here you are getting d is equal to 10.63 mm. so this is the nominal diameter of the bolt. Or otherwise you can open the, that is, machine design data book, or you look into the table, that is from table number 9.15. because we are designing for the bolt, you have to open the table number 9.15. so in that for the value, that is root or core dia, so how much for the root or core dia? So that is 8.93 root or core dia. So here from this table you are getting, that is the nominal diameter m hole. So you can solve both the method, either you can solve convenient one, which is convenient you can refer that. So here in this session I am referring both the method along with the design data book as well as and remembering the equation method also. The standard diameter here we are getting, that is how much? m11. So this is the another simple problem here we have solved. If you have doubt, any doubt you can ask now. Otherwise we will proceed further next. You take down another problem. This is the one of the very important problem. So here the relative velocity is so far different from whatever the problem we have solved. Now take down a lever loaded safety valve has a diameter of 100 mm and blow off pressure is 1.6 newton per mm square. The fulcrum of the lever is screwed into the cast iron body of a cover. Find the diameter of threaded part of the fulcrum if the permissible tensile stress is limited to 50 MPa and the leverage ratio is 8. So anybody, let us you just try to solve this, or otherwise you write the data what he has given. So let carefully you can write down the data. A lever loaded safety valve has a diameter of 100 mm. 100 mm diameter is there, you can write it as the diameter of the valve as a 100 mm. So the given, he has given the diameter of the valve as 100 mm and the blow off pressure, the blow off pressure is 1.6 newton per mm square. Blow off pressure is 1.6 newton per mm square. The fulcrum of the lever is screwed into the cast iron body of a cover. Find the diameter of a threaded part of the fulcrum if the permissible tensile stress is limited to 50 MPa and the leverage ratio is 8. It is permissible stress is sigma t is equal to 50 newton per mm square and leverage ratio he has given 8, and find the nominal diameter of the. So before solving this, so first of all we have to, so related to this the, so usually I think you know that in the safety valves, so in the safety valves we are having the lever to release the pressure. This is basically, it is designed on the the threaded part is there. So over the the lever, hand lever, which slides over the threaded portion is there. So here we have to find out that threaded part, the design of the threaded portion of the safety valve. So here he has given. So based on this data, we are going to calculate the some other the parameters, and finally we are going to design this one. Okay. So here, first of all, we have to find out what is the amount of load is acting. That is, because of the safety valve is there. So either we are using for the steam engine or in some other gas operations. So first of all, we have to find out what is the amount of the load is acting on the safety valve. So that we have to find out, that is force or load. So we can thread. We know that force or load acting on the valve is given by, let us, we can consider it as a, so force, that is, here we are write it as it, the total force F is equal to area into pressure, area into pressure. The diameter of the valve is given. So from that diameter of the valve, we can easily find out the area of that valve, that is threaded portion, which is mounted for the safety valve. That is area into pressure. Area is pi by 4 d square. Area is, that is, which is equal to pi by 4 d square into pressure. Substitute the value, pi by 4 into 100 square into 1.6. Now you do the calculation. Do it nearly the total load. How much total load is acting on the safety valve? So after simplification, nearly you are getting, that is 12,568 newton. That this is the total load is acting on the load. Okay, that is the safety valve. Now the load on the lever end. So here there is a one. Now we have to find out the lower load at the lever end. Is given by, you can write it as a, the leverage, that is total load divided by the leverage ratio. So that will give the, at the lever end, the what is the load is acting. So because we are using the hand lever to operate the safety valve. So from that, so we can, that is the total load is there. So this is the total gas load is acting on the safety valve. So in that, yes, for the leverage ratio is given. We have to use that ratio to calculate the load acting on the lever end. Okay, because this lever weight is also included in the, that load is also added in the safety valve. So for that, we have to calculate this. This is calculated by total load divided by leverage ratio. So that will give the load is acting on the lever end. So here, 12,568 divided by 8. So here nearly we are getting 1,571. Okay. So this is not a final one. So here we have to deduct the value. The total load is acting 12,568 newton. So in that, load acting on the lever end is 1,571. So therefore, the net amount of that load which is acting on the threaded portion of the safety valve is nothing but, it is difference between these two. That is, the net load, which is, can say it as a capital P, which is on the fulcrum of the lever, is equal to, that is, F minus W. So here you have to simple 12,568 minus 1571. So nearly you are getting, so that is how much you are getting. That is 10,997. So that is 10,997. This much amount of this the load on the threaded portion of the safety valve, the net, this much amount of load is acting on that threaded portion. So based on this load, now we are going to design the threaded portion dimensions of that safety valve. So therefore, already we know that. Next, we are proceeding as usual. So when the bolts are subjected to the tensile loading, so it is given by, so it is P is equal to pi by 4 dc square into sigma t. Okay, so use that equation, P is equal to pi by 4 dc square into sigma t. Now you substitute the value here. P is already known. Then we have to use the P. 10,997. And the DC square you have to find out. Sigma t is already known. Substitute the value. So substitute the value and you find out for the DC square. Just you rearranging the term. Therefore, here the DC square is equal to 4 into P divided by pi into sigma t, that is 4 into 10,997 divided by pi into 50. So here you are getting 280 mm square. So this is the DC square, the value of the root core dia square, that is core diameter in square. Therefore, to quote the square root of this, so we are getting DC is equal to, that is I think square root of the 280, that is 16.73. okay, 16.73 mm. This is the root dia or core dia you are getting. Okay, so now, so assuming the porous thread, that is DC is equal to 0.84 d, therefore the nominal diameter of the bolt, that is small d, which is equal to DC divided by 8, 16.73 divided by 0.84, which is equal to 19.91 mm. So this is the nominal diameter of the threaded portion of the safety valve. We are getting 19.91 mm. It is nearly, it is equal to 20 mm or M20. Or you can use the machine design data book. So in that table, look into the table 19.9.15. So you go through that. You find out for the 16.73 nominal diameter. So from this table, so here also we are getting M20. So from this table also you are getting the value is M20. So like this you have to solve the problem. This is one of the very important and little bit tricky is there. So first of all, that is the load calculations are there. So total load, initially total load we are getting, from that total load, so we have to deduct the load acting on the lever end. So difference between that will give the net load is acting on the safety valve, threaded portion of the safety valve. So we have to utilize that and finally we have to proceed in the same manner. So this is the problem. So let us next we will move on to the another one. Next to table. An electric motor weighing 10 kN is lifted by means of an eye bolt. The eye bolt is screwed into the frame of motor. The bolt has porous threads. It is made of plain carbon steel 30C8 with yield tensile stress 400 newton per mm square and a factor of safety is 6. Determine size of the bolt. So here this is another important problem. An electric motor weighing 10 kilo newton. Okay, so the first of all you have to write, that is the tensile load, given that the eye bolt made of, that is plain carbon steel, that is 30C8 is there, and yield tensile stress is sigma yt is equal to 400 newton per mm square, and the factor of safety has given 6. Okay, determine the 10 kN, that is the tensile load, yes, 10 kN, that is 10 into 10 to 3 newton he has given. Okay, so before proceeding into the further, so already we know that from the basics of strength of material, so to design the bolt based on the tensile stress, we have to find out the allowable tensile stress. So, but he has given yield tensile stress. So yield tensile stress is different, permissible or allowable tensile stress is different, and he has given factor of safety. So already we know that from the basics of strength of material, that is the allowable or permissible shear stress, which is allowable or the permissible tensile stress, which is equal to yield tensile stress divided by the factor of safety. So this is from the basics of strength of material. So here sigma yt is the 400 divided by 6. So therefore, after simplification, you are getting 66.66 newton per mm square. So this is the permissible or the allowable shear, the allowable tensile stress inducing in the eye bolt. Okay, allowable the tensile stress inducing in the eye bolt. So this is 66.66. So this is the value we have to use in further for solving the or designing the this eye bolt. So then. So the nominal diameter we have to find out. So already we know that when the bolts are subjected to the tensile loading, is given by that is pi by 4 dc square into sigma t. Okay. Now you substitute the value here. Substitute the value, and you rearranging the term for dc square. Dc square is equal to p 4 into p divided by pi into sigma t. So already. The P is known, that is 10 into 10 raised to 3, that is 4 into 10 into 10 raised to 3 divided by pi into 66.66. So therefore, here after the simplification, we are getting 191 mm square. So you took out the square root of the this, you are getting the value of DC. So that is square root of 191. Square root of 191 nearly we are getting 13.82. 13.82 mm is the root of the core diameter. Now once again assuming the porous thread, then this is equal to 0.84d. Therefore the nominal diameter of the port D is equal to DC divided by 0.84. That is you are getting after the simplification and calculation nearly you are getting 16.42, that is 16.42. 16.42 you are getting, okay, 16.42, 16.45. So this is the nominal diameter of the bolt, or you can use the from the design data book. It is on the 9.15 table. So in that, for the root or core dia, 13.82. For 13.82, so here for the 13.82, the nominal diameter of the bolt is, once again it is M16. Same, M16 is there. M16 is the nominal diameter of the bolt for the this one. That is, this is the bolt which is used for the an electric motor eye bolt. Okay, M16 is. If you have any doubt related to this, you can ask now. Otherwise, we will proceed further. So, I think I have covered a lot of problems in all the previous section along with this. So, this is about the designing of an eye bolt. If you have any questions, otherwise so we will proceed further. Now you can take down the some of the homework examples. First one, you take an engine cylinder is 300 mm in diameter and the steam pressure is 0.85 newton per mm square. If the cylinder head is held by 8 studs, find the size, assume the safe tensile stress as a 36 megapascal. So here this is the question. So clue I will give, already you have solved in this previous problem. The same cylinder diameter he has given, steam pressure is given, and number of bolt he has given, and tensile stress is given. First of all, here you have to find out the total force or load is acting on the steam engine, okay, cylinder. So that you have to find out, that is the pressure is equal to, so from that, okay, force is equal to pressure into that area is pi by 4 d square. So assume tensile stress is given, sigma t is given, n is given, use that equation and find out. Next, second one is a lever loaded safety valve has a diameter of 140 mm and a blow off pressure is 1.95 newton per mm square. The fulcrum of the liver is screwed into the cast iron body of the cover. Find the diameter of the threaded part of the fulcrum. If the permissible tensile stress is limited to 68 MPa and leverage ratio is 8. So this is the same, quite similar to the this problem. In previous problem we have solved in this session. So you try it. So first of all, here also same. The total load acting on the safety valve we have to find out. And then after that, the load acting on the lever end, we have to find out from the leverage ratio. That is total load divided by the leverage ratio will give the load acting on the lever end. So you deduct from the total load to the load acting on the lever end. So you are getting the net load which is acting on the threaded part of the safety valve. So from that we are once again you proceed in the same manner. Okay, you take down third one. An electric motor weighing 20 kN is lifted by means of an eye bolt. The eye bolt is screwed into the frame of the motor. The eye bolt has corrosive thread. It is made of plain carbon steel, having ultimate tensile stress of 600 Nm/mm² and factor of safety is 6. Determine the size of the bolt. So here he has given the tensile load he has given, that is 20 kN is there, and that is the eye bolt, the corrosive thread is given, it is made up of plain carbon, ultimate tensile stress is given, okay, factor of safety is given, okay. So here also you have to use the, already we have studied the yield tensile stress is, both are same, ultimate, that is to find out the permissible or the allowable stress, which is equal to ultimate divided by Fs. You make that. So then you are getting the allowable or the permissible tensile stress induced in the bolt material. That is, so you do the calculation, that is here I will tell the answer. That is ultimate is 600 divided by factor of safety is 6. So therefore the allowable stress you are getting here 100 Nm/mm². So you take that as the value for the further calculation and proceed in the same manner. So let us move the multiple choice questions related to these sessions. We will proceed in the next. So now you can take down the question. Question is like this. When the external load P is equal to pi by 4 dc square into sigma t, where the dc is, so from this he has given one equation. So from that dc is equal to what? Option A is equal, dc is equal to square root of 4 p into pi into sigma t. Dc is equal to square root of p divided by pi into sigma t. Dc is equal to square root of 4 p divided by pi into sigma t, or option D is none of the above. From that equation you let us rearranging the term for the dc and you find out the value. So here you are getting, which is the correct answer? Anyone? Try it. Here, the correct answer for this question is option A as well as option C, because they are both are same. That is, dc is equal to square root of 4p divided by pi into sigma t, 4p divided by pi into sigma t. There is a possibility in some cases there is the two answers are correct. So here also, for just for the checking purpose, I have given two answers. Whether you are giving the one answer or both the answers, so for that reason we have given two answers. Okay, the correct answer is option A as well as option C. Next, you take down another one. In a given equation PS, in a given equation the PS denotes, PS is equal to pi by 4 d square into tau into n. What does it mean? PS is equal to what? Option A is the tensile load, option B is the tensile stress, option C is the shear load and number of pins. So already in this session only we have solved some of the problems. So it is, PS denotes what? So here correct answer for this question is option C. So here the tensile, that is shear load, tensile load usually we indicate with the capital P, whereas the shear load, so we are indicating with the P subscript S. So that is PS is equal to pi by 4 d square into tau into sigma t. So let us will move on to the another question. The third question, force or load into radius is known as what? Force into radius is known as, option A is the torque, B is the pressure, C is the power, and D is the work. Already we have solved here the sum of the problem. So that is in the coupling bolts, that is which circle diameter he has given. So in that we are using. Here it is nothing but the basic definition of the torque is what? Force into perpendicular distance or radius or diameter by 2. So therefore the correct answer for this question is option A, torque. Pressure is different. Pressure is, that is force per unit cross sectional area. Work is different. Okay. Power is also different. The correct suitable, the answer for this question is the option A. Next, the last, we can consider another question. Calculate the value of sigma T, which is equal to sigma yt divided by fs, that is 400 divided by 6. A simple calculation is there. Do it. Simple division. Option A is the 70. Option B is 66.66 newton per mm square. Option C is 165 newton per mm square. And option D is none of the above. Do and calculate it. So here simple division, that is 400 divided by 6. So after simplification, here you are getting 66.6. So this is the correct answer for the this question. So up to here in the almost all problems we have covered, along with the some of the multiple choice questions, they are most fit for your further. So let us will move. So these are the some of the references which are we are using in the this session. So now, so thank you once again for attending the session patiently. Thank you on behalf of all our team members, LMS team members. Okay, thank you one and all. Thank you.